How is everyone this evening? I couldn't use the pulpit. The sun was blinding me. Well, I have an hour sermon, so don't look at your watches. Not really. Jesus was a great storyteller. And in telling the story, there always was a moral, there was a point. He tells about divas, which means in Latin, the rich one. He dressed in fine linen, purple, which was very expensive. He ate splendidly every day. He went against the fourth commandment. 6 days you shall work, on the seventh day you shall rest and keep Sabbath. But he was feasting all the time, never worked. Not bad. Lazarus was a poor beggar. And the word Lazarus in Latin means God is with you. He's outside the guy's house. He's filled with sores. Now, he wasn't a leper, because if he was a leper, he would not be allowed into the town. And he wished to eat just some of the bread from Divas's table. You see, when the rich ate, they ate with their hands, of course. They didn't have silverware like we do. And they would clean their hands by chunks of bread, and they would throw the bread away. He wanted some of that bread so he could eat because he was starving. No one gave him the bread. Divas was not mean to Lazarus. He didn't kick him away from his house. He didn't abuse him. But his sin was, well, pay attention, he never noticed him. What a shame. He was in front of him, but he never noticed him. That was his sin. And Jesus goes on to tell the story. Lazarus dies and goes to heaven, sleeping in the bosom of Abraham, who was our father in faith. And when the rich man dies, he goes to hell. He sees Lazarus. Abraham, tell him to help me. Let him dip his finger in the water to cool my parched tongue down here. And Abraham says, well, when you were alive, you had Moses and the prophets. You did not listen to them. Lazarus did. And he has been rewarded, and you have been punished. Now, it's just a story. It probably didn't happen. That wasn't the point. The point of the story was, make sure you notice everyone around you, and you do something. You know, this is not magic. Everybody that goes to church doesn't go to heaven. You know that, I hope, right? Yes, Father. Come on, Chief, you know, yeah. So what you do here, when you leave, that's important. Forgiveness is not easy. No. But, you know, following Jesus, somehow you will be scarred. What does Paul say? By his stripes we have been healed. So when you're scarred for love of God, you put yourself out, you're going to be burnt. You're going to be disappointed. You're going to be hurt. But you always turn the other cheek. Why? Because Jesus did the same thing. And if we call ourselves Christians, followers of Jesus, our behavior should reflect his behavior. You know, Adam and Eve, that couple way back when, got us in this mess by Adam eating the apple. I hate to think it was an apple. I don't like apples. I can see if he got tempted by Eve with a nice dish of raviolis, then I could say, oh, okay. And when God finds out they sinned, what does Adam say? She made me do it. Yeah. So we're in a mess. We're in an imperfect state. We are all imperfect. But if you don't pass the one who is right in front of you, if you don't pass by without doing something, if they're in need, no salvation. So you got to put yourself out. And you got to do it with a sense of gladness. Nietzsche, the great German philosopher, said a few interesting things. Unfortunately, he went stark raving mad at the age of 45. But Nietzsche said, if you Christians, you Catholics, believe you have been redeemed, how come the whole lot of you look so unredeemed? Good question. Try to look redeemed. Some of you don't. It's imperfect, yeah, it's not complete, no. But we have been redeemed. By his stripes we have been made whole. That's why we as Christians are never crushed in the face of tragedy and hardships or terminal illness. No, never crushed. No, we're weighed down, yeah. I'm a cancer survivor myself. So we all weighed down. But we never lose hope. We never lose sight what is yet to come. You got it?